My biggest challenge is with the welding of any material is sooting. I don't like to see the fuzz around the weld, and if there is going to be sooting around it, I prefer it to be white. And sometimes I get a little bit of a dark or dingy colored sooting, especially on a restart. To reduce the sooting, I found that proper tungsten prep, proper tungsten. I have in the drawer here every kind of tungsten known to man. I've tried them all several times. That has helped out probably the most, is having the right tungsten for the application. This new machine here, the 350 versus the AeroWave, has far less sooting on the restarts. This is an intake flange and intake runner for a LS7 sheet metal intake manifold. And as we were talking earlier about the accuracy of the arc with the new inverter style machines, that I'm big into color matching. And when you start a weld, typically with a traditional style machine, it's going to be very white in this area here. This is where I started. But with the controls of this, the color match of this weld is actually fairly well. Okay, and also that if you look at the width of the bead here and the width of the bead here, that's the width that it is all the way around this part. Except for right here where this machine counter bore is here for the bolt hole, I cannot have this area be upset. So I have to narrow up the puddle so I don't upset this machine portion here. And with the accuracy of the inverter style machines, that's possible, whereas traditional style machines, this whole edge here would not be crisp and sharp. It would be completely compromised and melted in where it is not with the inverter style machines. I would say you almost can't even put the difference into words. It's that big. I would almost want them to invite them over and try my machine. It's the difference is just so huge. You honestly can't describe it. The arc accuracy, the manipulation of the controls, the controllability for personal weld styles is just, phenomenal.